Hello everyone, welcome to Yellowgreys. In this video, I'm going to talk about sequence and variable handling in UiPath story.
Hi there, what is sequence? For the smallest project, we will use sequence. They are suitable to linear process as they enable you to go from one activity to another seamlessly. It acts as a single block activity, and one of the key features of sequence is that they can be reused. Let's see how that works in reality. Go to UiPath Studio and create a new process. I will name the process as sequence demo. Give a detailed description of the project. I will describe the project as this project is about creating, managing sequence and variables, and click create. Now your process is ready to go. Click on open main workflow link in the workflow designer panel or press Ctrl Shift T to view the project workflow designer panel. Now your workflow designer panel is ready to develop your process. Leave this main page and go to design tab and click on new option, then select sequence. Enter the sequence name, and this name should be related to the process behavior of this sequence. Then click create. This is the sequence activity we are talking about. This sequence will be used for smallest project. Go to variable panel. This is the panel where we can create, maintain and change the variable name, type and scope. There are three ways to create variables. One is in the place of variable panel. Second method is in the property panel, and last one is in the activity. Let's get started with the first method. Make sure that before creating your variable name should be camel keys. Create a variable name as strEmployeName, because my plan will store an employee name in a variable, so that is why I choose a relevant name for the variable name. Then go to variable type. You can change the type of variable here. There is a list of different types of variables. In the previous video, I covered the different types of variables and how to use them. Also, I have added video link of variables types in the description below. Watch it before you continue this tutorial. And in the scope, you will get the activity name of all the sequence which you used in this process page. For example, I will drag and drop one more sequence inside this main sequence. Now go to variable scope. You can see both the sequence name. Later we will see how useful changing the scope is in reality. Now I will provide an employee name in the default value box. I will use the name Yellowgreys for the employee name. Make sure that the string variable value is always enclosed in double quotes. Now navigate to activity panel, then go to search activity box, enter rightline to get rightline activity. This activity prints a string or the value of a string variable to the output panel. Drag and drop the rightline activity into sequence activity block. Add the name of the rightline activity. For all the activity, leave the origin name as it is. It will help others to find the name of the activity in the future. I will add the name employee name result. This name should be related to the process behavior of the activity. And call the variable of employee name. To call the variable type, you first type few letters of your variable name or press Ctrl spacebar to get all the variable list you created for this process. And go to design menu and click on debug file option. You will get three types of debug options. One is file, debug and run. Click run file or use Ctrl F6 to run the current file. Click debug or use F5 to debug the whole project. Click run or use Ctrl F5 to run the whole project. Now click run file to run the current file. Wait till the execution is complete. Yeah, it's done now. Go to output panel at the left bottom of UiPath Studio. You can see all of the output from each activity execution as well as the amount of time each activity performed. Let's go and place one more activity into main sequence block. I will drag and drop as an activity. It's an important activity that is going to be used quite often in UiPath, and it enables you to assign a value to a variable. You can use assign activity to increment the value of variable in a loop, sum up the value of two or more variables, assign the result to another variables, assign value to an array, and so on. Now I will use the second approach to create a variable. Go to assign activity. Press Ctrl K in the to out argument box to set variable and create a variable to store employee city, str employee city, then press enter. Now go and check variable panel. You can see newly created variable name str employee city, and also you can see it in a property panel into to out argument box. On the assign activity, you can see a red alert message. This means that you must add a value to the activity. I will add city name Chennai as value. See, now the red alert is no longer active. And the next, I will use the third method of creating variable, same as before. Drag and drop assign activity, go to property panel and select to out argument box and press Ctrl K to set variable. Here I am going to create variable int employee age to store employee age and press enter. Now you can see newly created variable in the variable panel as well as in the property panel into out argument box. Go to assign activity. You can see a red alert message. Provide the value of employee age. I will enter employee age as 30. When it comes to number, don't use double quotation. Always use double quotations for only string values. Still you can see the red alert message. Go and read the alert message by hovering your cursor over it. It's the best way of knowing your error. It says compiler error encountered processing expression on 30. Option strict on disallows implicit conversion from integer to string. It means your provided value is an integer and you created variable type is string. What we do now? Go and change the variable type of employee age as integer 32. Make sure that you need to change the proper variable type whenever you create variable in the activity or the property panel. Now I want to see the output of all the variables. For that I will drag and drop two more rightline activities. I will call the employee city variable name into one rightline activity and employee age in other rightline activity. Here also you see a red alert message. Read the red alert message hovering your cursor over it. You will see the error message, compiler error encountered processing expression on integer employee age. Option strict on disallow implicit conversion from integer to string. It means I already explained the usage of rightline activity. The activity prints a string or the value of a string variable to the output panel. Because the employee age is not a string, we must convert it before using it in the rightline activity. I will convert it as a string using the function .toString followed by the integer variable name. And other most important thing in development is naming convention of the project. Select your process sequence block and go to outline panel. You can see the hierarchy of all the activities in your process. And also a few activities that are repeated. This is the quickest way to get to the activity you want. You can't tell which activity is for which purpose. That is why I will add meaningful name for each activity. Meaningful name should be assigned to workflow files, activities, arguments, and variables in order to accurately describe their usage throughout the project. Now everything is ready. Here you see the asterisk symbol next to sequence name. It means your project not yet saved. Go to Design tab, click Save button or press Ctrl S to save your recent work. Let's run the process. Click on Run the file to check the result. The process is completed now. Go to Output panel. Here you see all the stored output of variables. Now again, come back to the question of what is sequence. Sequence are smallest type of project. They are suitable to linear process as they enable you to go from one activity to another seamlessly, and it acts as a single block activity. One of the key features of sequence is that they can be reused. Copy the current sequence, then create a new sequence and paste it into a new sequence. Here you can see all of the activities and variables that we generated earlier. It can be viewed here as well. You can change the value here also as you wish. Except for main, all workflow names should contain the verb describing what the workflow does. Recap. Sequence are the smallest type of project. They are suitable to linear process as they enable you to go from one activity to another seamlessly, and it acts as a single block activity. One of the key features of sequence is that they can be reused. Naming conversion. Meaningful names should be assigned to workflow files, activity, arguments, and variables in order to accurately describe their usage throughout the project. Variables should be camel case. Except for main, all workflow names should be contain the verb describing what the workflow does. I hope you are clear with this tutorial. Thanks for watching. Connect with us to get more tutorials.